how it smells like to be in the presence of God. Because I know it's life-giving, okay? The third thing, rhema is the spoken word. Rhema is the spoken word. That means something was inside me, then it comes out of me and I speak it. You see, anything that you speak, that means it either a witness. You see, in the court of law, if you say, I heard something, they're going to hear, say witness. I was there, I witnessed when it was spoken. You're part of life. And then the verdict, when it comes, they'll say, well, how was it spoken? Who said this? What time? Because they know at that moment, they begin to say, it's either premeditated or it was spontaneous or instant act or a random thing that you did. So whatever we speak has life. Remember these three things. What is rhema? Rhema is a living word. That means the way that I speak, they are not dead. Think of some of the things that you have spoken. They are alive and well. Oh, praise God. You have spoken some of the things. Think of some of the things how you curse yourself. You're battling and you're struggling. Oh Lord, why is something like this going on to be the way how it's happening? It's because you're spoken. There are some of the things that are my consequences now. I'm dealing with them because of my ignorance. I spoke them in my life. And I'm battling them right now. I may not go in detail. But if you ask me one-on-one, I'll not be ashamed to tell you one-on-one, but I cannot say it in public. But those are the things right now I'm paying the price. And the price is so hard because I kept on calling on it. Though it was permissive will, now it's happening in my life. You become what you confess. You become what you want to be. Now, faith comes by what? Hearing. What do you hear? The rhema. What do you hear? The living word. Okay? Faith comes by what?
Hearing.
You can never have faith until you hear something. What are you hearing? The life, the living word. What are you hearing? The life-giving word. What are you hearing? The spoken word. What are you hearing? The word of God. A number of people, we are struggling. I don't know how to do this. The Bible has everything. All what you need to do is to hear. Faith comes by hearing. But am I supposed to hear the living word? What am I supposed to listen to hear? The life-giving word. What am I supposed to hear? The spoken word. What am I supposed to hear? The word of God. Now Matthew chapter 4 verse 4 says, Jesus answered, it is written. It is logos. It is written, man shall not what? Live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God. I'm telling you, there are people that have literally gone out there and cast the home city chain. It will never grow. But I'm reversing those cases in the name of Jesus. And I'm saying they are liars in the name of Jesus. How many agree with me? Because it shall grow, we shall spread all over. Now I want you and I to begin to speak Home City Church as one of the churches that is going to be an international church. We have the white, the black, the Hispanic, the Indian, every race, every color is going to be in here. We're speaking the way, we're sending the way. The Bible says, I sent the way to heal their what? Their disease. What kind of way did God say? The living word. Amen. When we cast out devils, we don't go there and they try to bend some magic and saints, whatever they call, incense, those things that smells well. We speak the word. Devil, we rebuke you, be gone in the name of Jesus. We command you, go in the name of Jesus. You see, everyone wants to see a major miracle. Crippled rise and walk. I've had an opportunity, I've seen crippled rise and walk. We want to see the dead rise. I've had an opportunity, I've seen the dead rise. But we don't want small things we don't believe God for. All right, today I challenge you, don't believe God for these major things like seeing the dead. Begin to believe God for small things like headaches. Believe God for small things. And as you begin to believe God, see if God answers. Believe God that you can, before the end of the year, you will win at least two souls. No, I'm not asking for 20, two souls. Can you get down on your knees and say, I want to win somebody and see that they are literally convicted to the things of God. Believe God. If you don't believe God on that one, then I don't know what you're going to believe God for. Amen. Are we together? Acts chapter 17 verse 11 says, now the Berean Jews were of more noble character than those in Thessalonica, for they received the message with great eagerness and examined the scripture every day to see if what Paul said was true. They examined the what? When I preach here, I'm not the final man. If you go, I encourage you, go and research the word of God, study the word of God, find out if I have made a mistake or anything, and if there was a mistake, I'll stand corrected. Amen? So you go, you know, and they did the word of God. There's no one man who can tell you to say, what I preach is the final, is the authority. Only God, because he's the one who breathed the word. Who breathed the living way? Who inspired this way? So let's begin to speak the things that are not there as though they are here. Let's begin to speak the lives of our friends, our families, our dear ones, those who are far away, that they will be in the house of God. Let's begin to speak those things. The scripture are inseparable bond between logos and the rhema. In the scripture, there's inseparable bond. You can't separate them. Where there's weight, there's revelation. Where there's weight, there's revelation. There's no way how you can separate them. Do you know why these days people that have not seen signs and the wonders, miracles, people that are not able to see Jesus like the prophets of the Lord, is because our mind is occupied by the things of this world. We are not hearing the voice of God. We are hearing more what is on CNN, MSNBC, Fox News, every kind of news that is there. But we are not hearing. How many, don't raise your hand, but how many of us literally sit down and say, God, I want to hear the word of God. The living word, the life-giving word of God, the spoken word of God. If you begin to walk in that, believe me, everything that you attach it to obey, because there is nothing that will never obey to Jesus Christ. Every knee will confess, every tongue will confess, every knee will bow down and say Jesus is Lord. So we need that living way. They always work together, the Logos and the Rhema. Matthew chapter 22 verse 59 says, Jesus replied, you are in error because you do not know the scripture, all the power of God. You are in what? Error. Because you do not know what? The scripture, all the what? The power of God. You know, these days we live in a time whereby you can even put, in your car, most of the cars, they have CDs. There's all kinds of DVDs, CDs that you can listen to. Memory stick. You can just stick it and you hear the word of God as much as you want. But still more people that don't understand the word of God. I'll be amazed if I ask a question randomly, will you tell me what is your favorite scripture? Someone will say, oh, you start scratching your head. That should come to you, either you're in your sleep or you're awake or whatever you're doing. It should be automatically. You know, my scripture verse, this is what it means. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. That's my scripture. What's your scripture verse? If you don't have a scripture verse, then something is wrong in your walk with God. If you only have one, you should have something when you are going through trials that you stand on. When you are going through victory, that you stand on. My scripture verse when I go through trial is Psalm 70. And when I read that, no matter what is happening, to someone it may never make a sense. But to me, when I read that, it's given by the Lord. So you need to know what God has for you. Spoken way. We need to begin to speak around this thing. We need to walk around. You know, this is one thing that I'm so surprised here in this part of the world where we are living in the United States. People, they are forced to come to the house of God. You go in other parts of the world, people, they don't even have a place where they can go and they call it a church. But yet, this building is as empty as it can be from Sunday after church until another Sunday. What about the people coming over here and they pray and they seek the face of God? There's nothing that will happen until we get into the mode whereby we speak the way to these walls. Otherwise, these walls, sooner or later, they'll become a mortuary where they put dead bodies. And I even factor in, they may end up being dead bodies. People will just come over here and they'll be cut out by the power of the Holy Spirit. But inside us, they are empty tombs. And I was speaking to somebody, I said, do you really know God? If you die today, will you meet Jesus? He says, I don't know about that preacher. He didn't know. Why? Because he didn't understand the word of God. I know. If I die today, I will be Jesus. What's rhema with? I want you to take this definition, what rhema with is. Rhema is usually a communication from God, designed revelation and empowered to apply to a specific situation. I'm going to say it again. The rhema is usually a communication. Put it for me there, John Mark. Rhema is usually a communication. Communication from God designed the revelation.